Now we've got a brand new look at this MMORPG.
You won't
head
fight
towards
it.
Its open beta on September 9th.
Vas a ver cómo me lo va a dar.
¡La alianza, carajo!
¡No!
¡No!
No, esto es la magia del Classic, gente.
The stories you've heard. They don't tell the whole truth.
The
island is indeed a place of legend. There is power and vast riches as well. But many who've sought to claim them have simply vanished without a trace. Your ship is docked and your crew assembled.
Qué bueno, bueno, gente. Cada vez menos. Cada vez menos. Cada vez menos.
And your fate.
Piel de gallina, piel de gallina. No falta nada, no falta nada.
I will say a prayer.
29 de septiembre, dijeron, gente. ¡Apa! ¡Epa! ¡Epa! Play Open Beta. 9 de septiembre al 12 de septiembre. 3 días de beta. What the fuck? Se la sacaron de la galera esta, viejo.
That was the Gamescom trailer for New World, and joining me now is the game director from New World, Scott Lane. Scott, how you doing?
I'm great, Jeff. How are you?
I'm great. You guys had a very successful closed beta test this summer, right? Tell us about it.
Yeah, we were thrilled and humbled by how that went. You know, over 1 million people showed up to play, and there were 2 billion minutes watched on Twitch. And it was just so fun for the team to get to play alongside everyone, watch those streamers, and we got so much good feedback. The team's even more focused on shipping a great game than they were before.
Now, the game is coming out September 28th, but before then, there will be a public beta for fans?
Yeah, we're opening it up to the public from September 9th through the 12th. So if you're not familiar with New World, come check it out. And if you want more information on how to participate, you can go to www.newworld.com.
Before we go, I want to ask you about post-launch content. What do you have planned for players after September 28th?
Well, we are completely committed to making Aeternum a living, breathing world that players will come back to again and again for years to come. So for us, launch is really the beginning. It's day one. We're going to continue to add features well beyond launch, and we're going to continue engaging with the players to help drive our goals and where we take the game. I can't get specific on what we're talking about, but I can give you some hints. Players have already been asking for more supernatural elements and more weapons. So we got a pretty cool way to combine those into a deliverable that they'll see shortly after launch. And then players have been asking for more group content and expeditions. So we're working toward that as well. And then, you know, with the holidays right around the corner, I'm pretty excited to see what that might look like on Aeternum.
All right. Thanks so much for joining us, Scott.
Thanks, Jeff.
Gente, del 9 de septiembre al 12 de septiembre va a haber una beta abierta. Van a poder participar todo el mundo. Todo el mundo va a poder participar de New World. Cualquiera. No hace falta que precompren el juego. No hace falta que compren nada.
I just saw the trailer and I've been hearing nothing but New World talk. That's all I'm hearing as of late. And I just want to give you all a chance. For those who are unfamiliar with New World, could you describe the game form and what they'd be getting into?
As a player, you're thrown into this haunted wilderness, this supernatural Isle of Aeternum, and you find out that there's fates worse than death here, that the beings are immortal, or at least you believe that they're immortal. And you take up arms with fellow players trying to battle back against the forces of corruption in this crazy supernatural setting. Action-based combat and various other systems.
I was going to say epic siege warfare. We've got challenging PvE expeditions, deep MMO systems, classless character progression,
crafting,
housing, fishing. The list goes on.
What is it about combat in New World that is so unique?
I'm attacking you at your head, or I'm shooting towards your head or your body. It's impactful and it matters. We register the collision everywhere.
Está diciendo cosas que no conozcamos.
I'm dodging, I'm blocking, I'm actively moving in the world just like a third person action
game. No está diciendo algo que necesite decirse.
Are there any interactions within the world or the world itself?
I think you hit the goal of this. Like, we really wanted this big immersive supernatural world where, like, we really reward exploration. You know, every hill that you crest over, there's a new space, a new area that's going to feel different and offer unique challenges, uncover mysteries, and like different parts of the world
really del mundo,
feel
new world.
Different from each other. So as you travel around, like, different parts of the world matter to you. Different resources are in different places.
De los recursos sort of, en diferentes
like,
lugares.
Encouraging that.
Lo que vas encontrándose en el mundo.
Sort of naturally find different parts of the map.
Now, we talked about the environment, and we read that there was some feedback with players saying, you know, with the discoverability, it was a much higher level of difficulty that they could possibly handle, rather than, you know, all the environments leveling up with them. Is that going to remain a part of the game?
As you progress through the world, we wanted you to feel like you're getting stronger, getting more powerful, okay. And your level ups mean something. So there are harder areas, like way up in the map, that like you don't want to go up there when you're, you know, level 10, because you're just going to get destroyed by the enemies up there. Because we wanted that progression. Players who spend a lot of time building up their skills and like learning new weapons, that they feel that progression, getting better.
Está hablando de la progresión del juego, de las skills, de las materias en armas.
Like, all
por si no sé, a ver.
I am curious, you know, something that I would like to ask about, because I am a big animal lover. Has there been a change in the decisions to have horses in the game?
¿Estás preguntando de las monturas? Well, ¿si habrá monturas en el juego?
Okay.
No le puede contestar en este momento, dijo.
we are listening to player feedback as far as travel concerns and things of that nature.
Están escuchando los players de la comunidad con el tema de montura, ¿no? Ah, van a poner la Golden Rage, van a poner una skin nueva durante la beta abierta, va a haber drops. Sí, va a haber drops. Y es esa skin que están viendo ahí. Pero esta no es la misma armadura que dieron la anterior vez, en la anterior beta, puede ser. Muy lindo skin, ¿eh? Muy lindo skin, muy lindo skin. Sensaciones que les dejó el juego. A ver. ¿Qué pregunta le hubiera hecho yo? ¿Qué pregunta le hubiera hecho yo? ¿Cómo va el desarrollo del juego? O sea, primero en principal, ¿cómo se ven ellos de cara al 28 de septiembre? Sí, la primera pregunta, ¿cómo se ven de cara al 28 de septiembre? ¿Qué piensan, sí, de todos los exploits que hubieron? ¿Si están trabajando en otro cliente aparte? ¿Si ya pensaron cómo pueden mejorarlo? Si el tema monturas por ahí en un futuro, a mí las monturas la verdad que me van y me vienen, pero hay mucha gente preguntando por monturas, esquivaron esa pregunta. A ver, hay un montón de preguntas que se me hubieran pasado por la cabeza para hacerles, ¿no? El tema de facciones, ¿cómo harían con la mecánica de las facciones? Si una facción es mucho más numerosa que la otra y sacan bastante diferencia y bastante influencia, ¿cómo piensan tratar esa parte? O la mecánica del fuerte. Hay muchas cosas para preguntarle, qué sé yo, no tan exhaustivamente, pero más que nada la pregunta principal es ¿cómo se ven de cara al 28 de septiembre? Eso es.